Hello everyone. Today we'll be dealing with the topic that is frequency scaling. Till now we have discussed about how to design as well as how to find the frequency characteristics of a low pass filter. So when I talk about the frequency scaling, once a filter is designed, there will be a need to change its cutoff frequency. For low pass filter, the cutoff frequency is FH. So, suppose if I will be designing a low pass filter, say for 1 kHz, this 1 kHz cutoff frequency has to be changed to some 2 kHz. So, whenever a filter is designed, there happens to be a time when we have to change the cutoff frequency. So, the procedure used to convert an original cutoff frequency, FH, to a new cutoff frequency, FH dash, is called as frequency scaling. That is, as I've said you, if the frequency, cutoff frequency of a low pass filter is 1 kHz and if I have to change it to 1.5 kHz, so changing the procedure used to change this 1 kHz to 1.5 kHz is called as frequency scaling. So this frequency scaling can be accomplished as follows. So the first step is to change the high cutoff frequency, we have to multiply the resistor value or the capacitor value, but not both, by the ratio of original cutoff frequency to the new cutoff frequency. That means first we need to find out what is the ratio of original cutoff frequency divided by the new cutoff frequency. That ratio we have to multiply either with a resistor or with a capacitor value, but not with a both value. So that is the first step. And we know that whenever we consider this resistor value or capacitor value, we have a standard values of resistors and capacitors. So suppose if we want 9.94 kilo ohm, but there is no standard value for, or there is no resistor having 9.94 kilo ohm. So we'll be using a standard value such that for 9.94, we can use a 10 kilo ohm resistor. Similarly, we have different capacitors like 0.01 microfarad, 0.1 microfarad, but there is no variable capacitors. So in the filter design, the needed values of R and C are not standard, as well as a variable capacitor will not be used. Therefore, we'll choose a standard value of capacitor and then calculate the value of resistor for a desired cutoff frequency. So we need to first find the standard value of capacitor, then using that standard value of capacitor, we need to calculate the value of resistor for a desired cutoff frequency. We know that the desired cutoff frequency FH or R value is calculated as 1 divided by 2 pi RC for higher frequency or 1 divided by 2 pi FC for a resistor. Now, this is mainly because for non-standard value of resistor, a potentiometer can be used. As I said, you 9.9 kilo ohm is not a standard value for a resistor. During that time, we can use a potentiometer, which is also called as a variable resistor. So, for example, we can use a 10 kilo ohm resistor or a potentiometer. Using that potentiometer, we can adjust that 9.94 kilo ohm and then use it for frequency scaling. So, when we do a frequency scaling, the first procedure is find the ratio of original cutoff frequency by new cutoff frequency, then multiply that value with either a resistor value or a capacitor value, then find the standard value of capacitor and find out the value of the resistor for finding the new cutoff frequency. So this procedure is called as frequency scaling. Now we can solve a problem related to this. First is we have to design a low pass filter at a cutoff frequency 1 kHz with a pass band gain of 2. That means you have to design a low pass filter, cutoff frequency FH is given as 1 kHz, pass band gain means AF is given as. Now, first procedure is find what is the, write down the cutoff frequency, that is FH is equal to 1 kHz. Next is we have to choose a standard value of capacitor. So, I'll be considering it as C is equal to 0.01 microfarad. Now, we have to calculate resistor value because cutoff frequency is given, C is there. We know the formula of the resistor, that is R is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi FHC. So, 1 divided by 2 pi into 1 kilo ohm into 0.01 microfarad. Which will you will be getting it as 15.9 kilo ohm. Now, there is no standard value for the 15.9 kilo ohm. We have 15 kilo ohm resistor, we have 20 kilo ohm resistor or a 22 kilo ohm resistor. So, what we do is we will be using a potentiometer of 20 kilo ohm. Using that, you can adjust it to 15.9 kilo ohm. Now, next is we need to find out the resistor values. We know the passband gain is 2. We know that the non-inverting op amp has a gain of AF is equal to 1 plus RF by R1. Since 2 is taken, you will get an equation in terms of RF as well as R1. It is around 1.586. So using that, you can adjust the resistor value. You can consider it as R1 is equal to RF is equal to 10 kilo ohm, so that the complete circuit with component values will be looking something like this. So you have to design, if it is asked for design, you have to calculate the values, then put it into the circuit and show the low pass filter design. The next question is, using the following frequency scaling technique, you have to convert the 1 kilohertz of a low pass filter to a cutoff frequency of 1.6 kilohertz with R1 is equal to 15.9 kilo ohm. Now, the question mainly uses a frequency scaling technique. I have told you the procedure. So you have to convert this 1 kilohertz to 1.6 kilohertz using the same resistor value, that is 15.9 kilo ohm. So the first procedure to do is we have to find out the ratio of original cutoff frequency divided by new cutoff frequency. Then we have to multiply either the resistor value or the capacitor value. Now, since the resistor value is given, we have to multiply that ratio into the resistor value. So original cutoff frequency given is 1 kilohertz. Similarly, new cutoff frequency is 1.6 kilohertz, which is equal to 0.625. So this ratio has to be multiplied with the resistor, which will give you the new resistor value. R is equal to 15.9 kilo ohm into 0.625 is 9.94 kilo ohm. Now, we know that 9.94 kilo ohm is not a standard value. So we can use R is equal to 10 kilo ohm potentiometer and then adjust it to 9.94 kilo ohm. So next procedure is, using the same frequency equation, we need to calculate what is the new cutoff frequency. That is, new cutoff frequency is FH is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi RC. So 1 divided by 2 pi into 9.94 kilo ohm into 0.01 microfarad. So FH is equal to 1.6 kilohertz. So this is how we will be changing the original cutoff frequency to new cutoff frequency using a frequency scaling technique. Next question is, we need to plot the frequency response of a low pass filter having a passband gain of 2 and FH is equal to 1 kilohertz. Now we need to show the frequency response of the filter. Now we know that for a low pass filter, first order, V0 by Vin is equal to AF divided by square root of 1 plus F by FH whole square. Now, we need to plot the tabular column first. You can consider the tabular column input frequency as well as the gain magnitude as well as in terms of dB is the one more column. So, I will consider from a lower frequency because it is a low pass filter. Since I am considering for the plot, I will consider only a few frequencies. That is 10, 100, 200, 700, 1 kilo, 3 kilo, 7 kilo, 10 kilohertz as well as 30 kilohertz and 100 kilohertz frequency range. Now, using this, we need to find out the V0 by Vn magnitude. I have mentioned you in the slide what is the equation for the gain magnitude. AF is already given in the question, it is 2, square root of 1 plus, F is considered to be 10. So, 10 divided by FH is nothing but 1 kilohertz. So 10 divided by 1 into 10 to the power 3 will give you equation or the digit as 0.01. So this 0.01 whole square will be 1 into 10 to the power minus 4 plus 1 will give you 1.0001. Square root of that answer will be around 1.00. So 2 divided by that answer will be again 1.9999, which you can approximate it as 2. So 20 log of 2 will give you 6.02. Now, since it is voltage, I told you in the previous low pass filter class, if it is voltage, it will be 20 log. If it is power, it will be 10 log. So it is 20 log of 2, you will be getting it as 6.02. Similarly, if you take for 100 hertz, using that equation, 100 divided by 1 into 10 to the power 3, you will be getting it as 0.1. So 0.1 square will be 0.01 plus 1 will be 1.01 Square root of that answer will be 1.0049. Similarly, 2 divided by that answer will be again 1.99. So it is 5.98. Similarly, you will be calculating all the frequency values and finding the magnitude of that and finding those magnitude which is given in the tabular column there, finding in terms of dB. Now, using this, you have to plot the frequency response of the filter. Now, how do you plot a frequency response? Now, whatever you have the magnitude on dB will be taken as voltage gain in dB in the y-axis. Similarly, for the x-axis, you'll be considering the frequency in hertz. So, considering this as your frequency response, you can plot for various values. So, it will look something like this. So, you have the x-axis as 10, 100, 200 till your 100 kilohertz frequency. Similarly, magnitude that is having the gain, since we have here, the maximum gain is 6, the minimum is minus 33.98. So we will be considering from minus 30. Similarly, above it is considered till 10, 20 or 10. Now we can plot there the 6, which is 6.02 for 10 kilohertz. Similarly, 5.98. And you can see the graph is decreasing at one particular frequency, that is 1 kilohertz. So after 1 kilohertz, the graph is decreasing. That is your transition region. So till the constant frequency, what you have the gain as 2, constant gain, that is called as your pass band, where you have the transition of decreasing, that is nothing but your stop band. So that transition roll off is nothing but minus 20 dB per dk, which shows you that it is a first order filter. As well as maximum gain, you have to plot the 3 dB line, where the 3 dB line is cutting your main frequency graph. So that will give you the cutoff frequency, fh is equal to 1 kilohertz. Similarly, you will be plotting it in the semi-log graph sheet in your practical classes. So this is how you plot the frequency response of the filter. Now next, we'll be dealing with the topic. So till now, we had studied, so this is the graph of your first order filter, how the frequency response is drawn, similarly like the previous one. And the next topic we'll be studying now is the second order low pass filter. Till now, we have discussed about the first order low pass filter. Now, the stop band response having around 40 dB per decade roll off is obtained with the second order filter. Because in the first order filter, as said you, the roll off factor will be around 20 dB per decade. Similarly, in the stop band response having a 40 dB per decade roll off is obtained with the second order low pass filter. Again, first order low pass filter can be converted. Can be used into a second order filter type by using an additional RC network. I'll show you it in the figure. Now, second order filters are important because when you design a higher order filter, we require the second order low pass filters or second order filters. So, gain of the second order filter is set by using R1 and RF. So, this looks something like this. Now, second order filter, you can see, I told you the order of filter can also be defined by using a resistor and a capacitor. If you have one resistor and one capacitor to the input of the filter, it is called as a first order filter. Similarly, you have two resistors and two capacitors, which means it is a second order filter to the input of the op-amp. So you can see in the figure there is two additional resistors which has been used and two additional capacitors. That means to the first order filter, we are adding one more resistor and one more capacitor. So here gain of the second order filter is set by R1 and RF. While the higher cutoff frequency, which is FH, is determined by using R2, R3, C3, as well as C2 capacitors as follows. So here it is given as C1 and C2 in the figure, or you can consider it as C2 and C3 because the equation, I think I've written it as C1 and C2. So this is how the design is used. You have the feedback network, that is RF, as well as R1 is considered to be 27 kilo ohm. Now here, when you consider this second order filter, the voltage gain magnitude, or you can say the higher cutoff frequency of the filter, is similar to your first order, but FH is equal to 1 divided by square root of 2 pi. Instead of R, you have two resistors here, so it will be R2 into R3. Similarly, you have two capacitors, C2 into C3. So it will be FH is equal to 1 divided by square root of 2 pi R2, R3, C2 and C3. So voltage gain of equation of your low pass filter is same as the previous, but since you have two RC networks, it will be instead of square root of 1 plus F by FH whole square, it will be AF divided by square root of 1 plus F by FH to the power 4, where AF is equal to 1 plus RF by R1 is the passband gain of the filter. F will be the frequency of the input signal in hertz, as well as FH will be your higher cutoff frequency, which is used for the high cutoff frequency, which is used for the second order low pass filter. Now here again, voltage gain equation, as I've told you, AF is 1 plus RF by R1 is the gain, F is the frequency, as well as FH is the higher cutoff frequency. Now again, there is a frequency response of the second order low pass filter. The general difference in the frequency response of the filter is the roll-off factor in case of a first order filter is minus 20 dB per decade, whereas you can see the transition region here, it is having a stop band response having 40 dB per decade. Again, for the design of the filter, different types of identical, we need to choose the value of higher cutoff frequency. Now, as I said you in the previous low pass filter of first order also, there were certain design steps which has to be used for designing a low pass filter. Similarly, we have certain filter design for the first order low pass filter as well. Now here also you have the first procedure of filter design is you have to choose a value of higher cutoff frequency. What is the value of the cutoff frequency? For example, I can consider it as F is equal to 1 kilohertz. Then to simplify the design calculations, what we do is we set the R2, R3, which is equal to R as a resistor value, as well as C2, C3 is equal to C, then choosing the value which is C should be less than or equal to 1 microfarad. Then you have to calculate the value of the resistor R, that is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi FH into C, and then select the value, because you know there are equal resistors, that is R2 is equal to R3 and capacitor C2 is equal to C3. So the passband voltage gain what you have, that is AF is equal to 1 plus RF by R1 of the second order low pass filter, which has to be equal to 1.586. So RF will be equal to 0.586 R1. Similarly, the gain is necessary to guarantee that Butterworth response. So hence, you have to choose the value of R1 should be less than or equal, RF should be less than or equal to 100 kilo ohm, and then you have to calculate the value of R1. The whole procedure is similar to your the first order low pass filter, but the value of capacitor what you choose should be less than or equal to 1 microfarad, as well as two resistors and two capacitors should be equated to R and C, as well as the RF should be having a value less than or equal to 100 kilo ohm, where such that RF is equal to 0.586 R1, and then calculate what is the value of R1. So the same thing is given in the figure also. So to design a filter, you have to calculate the setup by R2, R3 is equal to R, C2, C3 is equal to C. Choose the value of C less than or equal to 1 microfarad. Then you have to choose the value of R and then design the filter for required frequency. The next question is, you have to design a second order low pass filter at a high cutoff frequency of 1 kHz. Now you have to design it. That means you have to find out the value of resistor as well as capacitor. Then you have to design a low pass filter by finding the value of R1 and RF as well. Then using that, you have to draw the frequency response of a low pass filter, that is second order. Now, as I've said you in the filter design, the first step is we write what is the cutoff frequency. It is already given in the question, the cutoff frequency is around 1 kilohertz. So using that cutoff frequency as 1 kilohertz and making the next step is we have to choose the capacitor value. That is C2, C3 should be some value which should be less than 1 microfarad. So I've considered it as 0.0047 microfarad. The third step is you have to calculate the resistor value. So R2 is equal to R3 is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi FHC, with what is 1 divided by 2 pi 1 kilo into 0.0047 microfarad. Now, whatever the answer we get, it is 33.86 kilo ohm. So we have a standard resistor of 33 kilo ohm. So we can use a 33 kilo ohm resistor. The next step is we know RF is equal to 0.586 R1. So using that 0.5, so you get this equation because RAF is equal to 1 plus RF by R1. Since AF is given as 2, and if you simplify, that is 1 plus RF by R1 is equal to 2. So 2 minus 1, you will be getting it as 1, where RF by R1 will be equal to, that is, since you can take the LCM of that, R1 will come above. So here also R1 comes, so it will be 2 minus 1 of that R1, which is RF is equal to 0.586 R1. So using this equation, now we have to choose for R1. Let the R1 value what you take should be less than 100 kilo ohm. So you can consider it as 27 kilo ohm. Using the 27 kilo ohm, RF will be 0.5866 into 27 kilo, which is 15.82 kilo ohm. Now we know there is no standard resistor for 15.82. You can use a potentiometer of 20 kilo ohm resistor, and then you can adjust it to 15.82 kilo ohm. So R2, R3 will be, so the design parameters which is required is, required components are R2, R3 is equal to 33 kilo ohm, C2, C3 is equal to 0.0047 microfarad, R1 is equal to 27 kilo ohm, and RF is equal to 15.8 kilo ohm. So you can use a 20 kilo ohm pot. So the complete circuit for this design, I'll show it to you in the next slide. Before that, we have to next question of this is, so you have to draw the frequency response of the network. So we have seen how the frequency response of the network was drawn in the previous case of first order filter. The same procedure will be used in case of drawing the frequency response of the filter. So we know the gain voltage equation of a low pass filter of second order is AF divided by square root of 1 plus F by FH to the power 4. So we can use the same procedure, consider the input frequency from 10 to 100 kilohertz, calculate gain magnitude using the same equation. Now we know AF is equal to 2, F will be 10 divided by 1 into 10 to the power 3. So which will give you 0.04, 2 to the power 4 will give you 1 into 10 to the power minus 8 plus 1 will give you again 1.000 approximated almost to 1. So 2 divided by that answer will be around, sorry, square root of that 1.000001 will give you around 1. So it will be around 2 divided by that answer will be 1.59. So 20 log of 1.59 will be 4.02. So you get one value. Similarly, you can calculate for one more. You can take 200. So it will be 200 divided by 1 into 10 to the power 3 kilohertz. So it's 10 to the power hertz. So it will be giving you around 0.4. 2 to the power 4 will be 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 3 plus 1 will be around 1.0016. Square root of that answer will be around 1.00007. So divided by the AF gain, that will be around 1.58. Then 20 log of this 1.58 will be 3.97 you'll get. You can approximate it to 4. So using this equations, you can calculate for all the values. Now here you can see the maximum gain what you have is 4.01. Whereas the minimum gain what you have is minus 75.99. So you have to plot the y-axis taking voltage gain in dB and x-axis in terms of frequency. Now you can see the figure. So this is the design of the first question part A, which was to design a second order filter with a frequency 1 kilohertz. So you have designed it and the circuit looks like this. R1 was 27, RF was 15.8 kilo ohm. We'll be setting it using a 20 kilo ohm potentiometer. R2, R3 was 33 kilo ohm. C2, C1 was 0.0047 microfarad. So using this to design the second order low pass filter. Now the frequency response will look something like this. So minimum was around 55, so we'll be considering minus 60. Maximum was around 4, so you can take 10. So plot the values for each of the frequencies and you can see plot a 3 dB response. So at 3 dB there is a intersection, so which will be giving you exactly the cutoff frequency FH is equal to 1 kilohertz. So whatever the frequency is from 10 to 1 kilohertz, it is the passband frequency with a constant gain. Then there is a transition from a passband to stop band, which will be giving a roll off rate of minus 40 dB per decade for a second order low pass filter with a 3 dB. So that is the stop band response. So this is the procedure to draw the frequency response of the low pass filter. Either it can be your first order filter or either it can be your second order filter. So this is how you plot the frequency response. So in the next class we'll be studying what is the design or how to design a high pass Butterworth filter, both first order as well as the second order. Thank you.